What's up guys, Steve Chen here, welcome back to my channel. You can see, got the two easy mount for bow mounting or the gunwale mounting. Today I'll show you how I mount it on my boat and which one I prefer and why. Let's start with the dimensions. This is like a 10 inch, about the regular size for your trolling motor mount. And the width, you can see, 2 3/4, 3.5 here. Let's start with this one, and you just need to put it here and make sure the angle here supporting on your hull, and you tighten the screw. Make sure here it's attaching to the gunwale. Okay, you can see it's very secure and actually cannot move it without shaking the boat. It's good enough. And this one is much bigger, as you can see, much wider. This is some friction. Make sure your trolling motor is mounted securely. And it's much wider, as you can see. Take a measurement, about 9 inch wide here, 3.5 or 3 here. So make sure your gunwale is less than 3. This one, 3.5. Okay, same thing here. Make sure the support is in position towards the hull. This is the right way, I guess. And this is the lock. Make sure the position is locked. Right, looks like it's secure enough. You can see it's pretty sturdy, right? Now let me tell you why I prefer this one over the other one. So you can see this is narrower, this is wider. That means when you press it really hard, you can see the hull is bent, right? This means all the pressure is applied to the small area. But this one, since it's wider, the area is much bigger. You press it, you can see it barely deforms the hull, which is better. Because I'm not sure how thick the aluminum is and how strong it is. So I have more confidence in the wider one. It has a larger area of support on the hull. And I'll just put my trolling motor on top of it. Pretty easy. Like you do with your transom mount. Nice and secure, right? So one last point. And here, you see the hole. If you want to use this one, you have to move the pin here from the original mount to here, and I'm not sure if the every trolling motor mount is compatible with the diameter here, so I wouldn't bother with that. Alright, I guess that's it for today's video. I'll put the two drawings inside the box right here, and you can check it out. And I also put the purchase link of these two in the description if you guys want to get it for your boat. I think this one is pretty sturdy for the thin hull aluminum boat. And that one is more convenient if you have a very strong gunwale, maybe on a bass boat. Okay, hope you guys enjoy watching this video, and I'll catch you in the next one.